So another example is when you actually start to click on documents. Now we can do this one document individually, or we can do this at all documents, folders of documents. Again, we could do the whole site if we wanted to. Within the actual ribbon, once you've got the relevant SharePoint permission, you'll see a number of different options. So I've got files here, and I can actually manage these files. So I have a content manager dropdown, and this comes back to those options that I had so before, the manage, the finalize, the relocate, and archive. Now I'm actually going to relocate this document. Now what's going to happen is going to come up in here, and again, I could do this to one document, I could do it to many documents. It already has this document in a managed state, so it's already aware that this document is there. It's got a metadata record sitting in Content Manager, and we'll just copy this to have a look about that in a second. It's given me where it's going to go. Again, I've preset some defaults at the site level, so we can actually go through and actually see where this is going to go, what the retention schedule is going to be. When I actually go through and click OK, now again, this is going to go off on a process, move the document, it's going to get into a queue, and effectively, if we close this and go and have a bit of a look, what's going to happen if we search this record number is the actual document will start to appear. So again, the metadata record's still there because we had it, and just as it happened right then, we've physically moved that document into Content Manager. Now, if we go back and have a look in SharePoint, we refresh that page, that document's now no longer sitting in this library of folders. Now, again, I could have done that to one, I could have done that to many. I can also have this automatically set up. So again, based on triggers or any sort of rules, this can actually happen automatically as it goes and progresses.